A super quick overlook of precision snapping in Blender with CAD transforms. What's up, I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about a very quick overview of one of my favorite Blender add-ons, CAD transforms. I've done a very long video on this before, it's linked in the card or down in the description, but I want to make this video just to introduce you to CAD transforms, along with showing you the absolute basics so you can really get a running start with it. Get a hold of CAD transforms, go over to Stephen Ledger's Gumroad page. The link is down in the description. Click on the CAD transforms for Blender, and right here, you can get it for free, but please support this guy because you're going to see this has really changed the workflow of Blender in an amazing way. So you can put in whatever you want there, add to cart, and then download it, and now we'll go and install it. You install CAD transforms like any other add-on by going into Preferences, Add-ons, clicking the install and the file that you've just downloaded, click that, wait about 10 seconds, and then turn it on here. Here you're going to see a whole bunch of settings, and if you want to know more, head over to the other video. CAD Transforms is different compared to other add-ons as you have to enable it, and you'll have it by right this button here. You click this, and this enables CAD Transforms. The main difference here, once it's on, when you click on an object and you hit G to move it, it's not going to move it. What it's going to ask you to do is to select where you want to move it from. You can change where you select this movement from by looking at all the different snapping options here. I'm going to hit Escape to get out of the selection, and you will also see it here in the active tools. There is a whole bunch of shortcuts to pick which these snapping points are. So right this minute we have vertex snap, so we can go ahead, hit G and go vertex snap from this vertex to that vertex there. We can also go about and do the exact same thing but for face centers, for instance. So let's go ahead, let's hit G, let's go for the bottom face center, which is Shift F, and now we've got it clicked onto the face center of the bottom. And now instead of clicking to another face center, let's go ahead and hit spacebar to cancel everything, hit V to snapping to vertex, and let's go from the face center to this vertex center there. So that there, in essence, is CAD transforms. It lets you do incredible movement very easily of snapping in many directions. Now, if you want to see this in a lot more detail, there is the video I've created before. So that there was the snapping. Now, there's also scaling. To scaling, you have to set the axis itself. Once it's scaled, you have this scale here, which is 1D. Pressing tab gives you 2D, and tab again gives you 3D. Here, you can also put in a measurement. So let's say 3 millimeters, and there we go. We've now scaled this up into 3 millimeters. Now this applies the same, sort of the same with rotation. So if we hit R, we have to select an axis we're wanting to rotate on. So let's go for this edge right here, and there we have our axis of rotation. On top of that, we can put in 45 degrees, and then we can even do something called a stack transform. And let's go ahead and let's say on the Y, we also want to go 45 degrees. Then we hit enter, and that there is stack transform. There is so much that I'm not covering here in CAD transforms, but just be aware that that is the fundamental basics of CAD transforms. It's snapping to snapping to any of these snapping points. So we have vertices, edges, faces, a grid, edge centers, perpendicular, parallel, face centers, the normal, and even the origins of elements. So this has been a super quick overview of CAD transforms. And trust me, there is 30 times more information to cover, but for that, I really encourage you to go and check out my full video where I've covered absolutely almost everything of this add-on. For those of you that have encountered this video right in the middle of the Blender Precision course, I know this video has been very fast-paced, and the only reason why I've put it in is because I don't want it to catch you out, because I will be using CAD transforms in the next video in the Blender Precision series. So see this more as an introduction video to CAD transforms to see how I have it and how I use it within our next video. Anyway, a huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome. And thanks for watching. Keep making and let the quest continue.